Liza, I have got incredible news.
Really? You sound like you just won the lottery.
Not quite, but close. Your brother is getting married. I am so excited.
That's awesome.
He is marrying that girl he got pregnant, and her parents are loaded. What a lucky strike.
You mean Sandra? They were in a relationship. She is not some client he got pregnant.
I thought Adam's career as a fitness trainer had no prospects, but now he is marrying a girl like Sandra. Her father is going to give Adam a job in his company.
That's nice for Adam.
Soon my son will be rich and I will have an incredible, lavish lifestyle. My life is going to change.
You will have a lavish lifestyle? How is this about you?
Of course. Sandra's parents don't want their daughter to be in a relationship with a fitness trainer. So once she got pregnant, they decided it was time for the couple to get married and for Adam to join the family business. Bravo! What a clever son I have.
I am pretty sure that wasn't some grand master plan by Adam. Two people just happened to fall in love and their lives aligned. It is not about money.
My son is marrying into money and soon he will start earning a lot too. So it's only natural that as his mother, I will have access to his massive wealth.
Okay.
You, on the other hand, have greatly disappointed me by marrying a middle-class office worker and having kids with him. Couldn't you have had a rich man's baby?
Mom, that's my husband you are talking about. That's your son-in-law. We have kids together. How can you say that?
He is just a lowly office worker, and his family has no wealth. How does it feel cooking and cleaning for a husband only for him to bring home a meager salary?
We are in a loving relationship of 10 years, and we are very happy. He earns just enough to fulfill our needs.
Only just enough. Maybe you should divorce him, take the kids, and get lots of money and child support. Ha ha ha.
I won't do any such thing. Please don't insult my husband like that. I won't tolerate it.
It's so strange how my son found a rich woman, even though I always told you to find a rich man.
Yeah. You always used to say marrying our father was the greatest mistake ever, and you wished you had married a rich man.
And yet you didn't take note. I always told my son to do something so he will get rich, and at least he found a nice, rich girl for himself.
No wonder Dad divorced you. Life isn't all about money.
If you want to be happy and live a fine life, then there is no life without money.
Hey, Liza, how are you guys doing?
We are good. Congratulations, I heard there's a wedding in the works.
Yes, thanks. I wanted to inform you about that. You, Ben, and the kids are invited. Your invitation will soon arrive in the mail. Be sure to attend.
Of course. We wouldn't miss it for the world. This means we have to go shopping to get ready for the wedding.
Hey, hey, I guess you do. Start preparing. Drop your kids by. They are going to be the flower girl and ring boy. We have to start practicing.
Sure. Mom is really happy. She thinks you are going to be so rich.
Geez, Mom. Yeah, it's ironic how much she has been buttering me lately, considering she used to shame me for working as a fitness trainer, but it's not like I am going to get rich overnight.
Well, all that does not matter anymore to her, because Sandra's father is going to give you a job in his company.
It is not as ideal as it sounds. There is a lot of training I have to undergo, and there are some college courses I have to take. For now, I am playing second fiddle to Sandra and her family.
So you will be like an intern?
Something like that. I am not ready for an important role yet. I have a lot to learn and a lot of hard work to do, but I am lucky to get this opportunity.
You are. Make good use of it. So Sandra is making all the money?
Yeah. I don't work nearly as much yet because she is pregnant and I take care of the house. So the kind of money Mom is expecting is nowhere in sight for a good while.
Wow. She has been saying that me and my husband are middle-class losers and I should divorce him and find a rich spouse like you did.
What? No, I can't believe Mom. I didn't get with Sandra for her parents' money. I don't know what she's expecting from me.
She thinks you will give her lots of money and she will live a lavish life.
As if. I am going to be super busy. I am making a career change after all. My father-in-law is so strict, I don't think I can waste his money like that without getting into serious trouble. Besides, we don't have access to all their wealth.
Of course. It's unethical, and he is being so supportive of you guys.
Yeah, unlike someone I know, I was hoping you will take care of Mom. Maybe keep an eye on her from a distance. I'm going to be super busy after the wedding.
I will, but I really can't bear her when she acts like that.
Don't worry, I will talk to her and explain the situation to her, so at least her unreasonable expectations die.
Wasn't it a marvelous wedding?
It sure was.
It was so lavish and elegant. Everything was simply marvelous, from the food to the decor to the bride and her dress.
Yeah, Sandra made such a beautiful bride.
I thought the baby bump was going to ruin everything, but it didn't. And that cake was gorgeous and super yummy.
Yeah, she was glowing and Adam looked wonderful too.
Unlike your wedding, where everything was so tacky, your dress was so simple and your cake was so tiny, and all your friends were nobodies.
Yeah, well, it was all we could afford at the time. My father-in-law isn't a CEO after all.
Thank goodness for Adam's well-to-do in-laws. Only if your in-laws were rich like that. Then you would have a lavish life, too.
My in-laws are nice to me, and that is all that matters. I don't need a lavish life. I am happy.
Pfft. And so many important people came to meet me at Adam's wedding. I think I made a few high-profile friends, too.
Because you are the groom's mother, so people were interested in meeting you.
Yes. My son is getting married into such an important family. His father-in-law is a CEO, and someday he might become a CEO, too.
And how does that make you special?
I gave birth to him, so that makes me special, too.
Right.
Do you know he has always been my favorite child?
You weren't too fond of him when he worked as a fitness trainer.
I knew all along that someday he would make something big out of himself. Now he is the only child I need.
What do you mean by that? You don't want me around?
Yeah, you can keep your distance from me and my son. It would be shame if all his important family members knew we were related to you.
Excuse me? I was at the wedding with my husband and kids. Everyone knows I am his sister. And I am your child, too.
Adam is all I need, and Sandra is the closest thing to a daughter I will ever have. You have always been such a disappointment.
Sandra has her own parents, and I am your biological daughter. Are you disowning me?
I don't want you around anymore. You are not needed anymore.
But you are my mother. How could you be so cruel?
It has to be done. I am sorry, but you choose to be poor, and we don't want to be around lower-class folk.
Lower class? Are you discriminating between your children on the basis of wealth? What kind of a mother are you?
I'm only doing what is best for me and Adam. It was embarrassing enough having you and your dirt-poor family at my son's wedding. I bet all those high-class folks were disgusted seeing you lowlifes there.
Everyone was really nice to us. In fact, you were the only one giving us a cold shoulder at the wedding.
I just couldn't stand the two of you ruining that grand affair of a wedding with your presence. I wish you hadn't attended.
You are being extremely rude. Since you have explicitly told me how you feel about us, I think it's time we cut ties with you. You won't get to see my kids anymore either.
Goodbye and good riddance. I am going to have another grandchild, so I won't miss your street urchin kids. Poor kids to have you two as parents.
Mom, don't bring my kids into this. I am not going to forgive you for insulting my children.
The truth hurts. You chose this life. I am sorry, but I simply don't need you anymore. It is time for me to climb up the social ladder.
You have always been selfish, but this is extreme behavior even for you. Well, good luck with that, Mom. I hope you finally get the lavish life you have so desperately been lusting after.
What has come over our mother?
What happened?
She has been bombarding Sandra with sickly sweet messages, inviting herself over to have lunch with my in-laws. It was so embarrassing, so I called to explain things to her. She didn't take it well.
What did she say?
Well, I told her I had made a career change and was super busy, and that Sandra and I didn't have any access to her parents' money, if that is what she was expecting. She completely lost it and started yelling at me.
I am sorry about that. Mom hasn't really been too nice to me either.
Mom was demanding I invite her to mingle with my in-laws and their upper-class friends immediately, so I blocked her number on both our phones. What did she do to you?
Mom told me that Ben and I were too poor to associate with her and you guys. So she basically told me that she has disowned me and she doesn't want to see us or her street urchin grandkids anymore.
Oh my God, that's horrible.
She said now Sandra is the closest thing she has to a daughter and the only grandkid she needs is your kid.
How despicable. Our mother does not have a conscience. Please don't listen to what she said. You guys are always welcome to hang out with us, unlike her.
Thanks.
We need to stay away from Mom. She is giving my in-laws the creeps. It would be so embarrassing if she cozies up to them.
Liza, Liza, something absolutely tragic has happened.
What? What's the problem, Mom?
Oh, it's absolutely horrible. Adam refuses to see me.
Really, that's all? I thought it was an emergency.
He and Sandra wouldn't respond to my messages and calls anymore, so I drove all the way to his house, and the guard turned me away.
Wow, so they wouldn't let you in.
Adam has moved into such a lavish house with his in-laws, and yet he refuses to even see me. There were so many expensive cars parked in the garage, and yet he still has his old car.
Gee, I wonder why.
He sent me an email. He said all I was after was money, and I am embarrassing him. And he doesn't have the kind of money I am expecting, so he is cutting me off. Boo-hoo!
Well, that's his decision. He wouldn't want to associate with poor folks like you after all. Why are you talking to me again? I thought you disowned me.
Oh, Liza, you are all I have now. It's not an ideal situation, but I will make it work.
Being around me is not an ideal situation.
You are the child I wouldn't have chosen if I had the choice. Oh, it hurts so much that my golden child would do this to me. You poor thing, you must be so jealous of your brother and Sandra.
I am not jealous at all.
But as soon as you divorce that destitute husband of yours and make him pay lots of child support, we will start looking for a sugar daddy for you to marry. Maybe dump the kids on Ben.
What? I am not leaving Ben or my children.
You will have to. The kids are just going to be a distraction.
I love my children, and I will not treat them the way you have treated your children.
I am afraid it has to be done. That's the only way I will be able to live a lavish life, now that Adam refuses to mingle with me. This is my only way to get all the riches that I desire.
You have gone insane. I will never, ever leave my family to be part of your schemes. What makes you think you could say all those cruel things to me and waltz back into my life?
I can't help it if you're poor, but I can certainly try to help you change. We are a family, and we need to stick together.
Just because you keep calling me poor, let me break some news to you. I have been running a home-based business the past few years. Ben works part-time because he has been helping me. We easily rake in $300,000 a year.
Oh my God, that's quite a number. Who needs that, Adam? You are my new favorite child.
I thought I was an embarrassing loser.
Oh, no, no, no. You and Ben are a power couple. I can't imagine you were raking in so much money.
We like to live within our means and save for our children's future. We are not exactly millionaires, but we are comfortable and we don't ever have to worry about money.
Liza, you clever girl. I always knew you had it in you. It's going to take Adam a good while before he starts earning. It's Sandra who has all the money, but you are the one with the money in this relationship.
Yeah, but you are not getting any money from me. You disowned me, remember?
No, no. We have to stick together, my dear. We are a family after all.
No way. You just showed me your true colors. I will never trust you again. I will never forgive you for all the horrible things you said about Ben and my kids and the way you treated us.
But what am I going to do? Where am I supposed to go? Ben already made it clear he wants nothing to do with me. You can't turn your back on me, too.
That's what you deserve for being so materialistic and treating your children like piggy banks.
Don't say things like that, Liza. I know. How about I come over dinner and I will bring the kids some presents?
No thanks. You are not seeing Ben or my kids ever again. And I have decided I am going to block you on everything. Don't expect any favors from me.
But I will be all alone. I am getting old. I need you guys.
Maybe that's exactly what you deserve. Goodbye, Mom.
Liza blocked Mom off everything and continued to enjoy her life with Ben and the kids. Mom tried really hard to reconnect with Adam and Sandra, but eventually they got a restraining order against her. When they finally had their baby, Mom was not allowed to see him. Mom spent the rest of her days all alone. She told everyone how her children turned their back on her and wouldn't support her in her old age in spite of being so well off, but everyone knew what she was like, so they didn't sympathize with her. Mom's relatives told her it's what she deserved for being a toxic parent towards her kids. She spent a lonely life. Her only visitors were her friends who were toxic mothers just like her. Together, they would badmouth their children and complain to anyone who would listen. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.